Hello. Choosing the most appropriate UI automation tool for testing web applications is a very challenging task. Lots of requirements need to be covered. This video supports you via comparing the most important features of the popular open source web testing tool Selenium with QF-Test. The first section we take a look at is the part of creating tests and how to run them during development. Selenium test cases will mostly be implemented in source code, like you can also see in my example. My example shows an implementation in Java using the TestNG unit test framework. The Selenium libraries can also be used in other programming languages, so you are not forced to use Java. Your test cases can make use of all the provided features by the utilized programming language, all of the features provided by the Selenium API, or by other APIs which are part of your project. In consequence of this, test cases can only be implemented and maintained by engineers having software development skills. A test run can be triggered by the means of your IDE. In my case, I have a launch configuration in Eclipse to do that. So I launch my test cases now. In a few seconds, the browser will get opened and two clicks will be performed, which happens very fast. The results of the test execution can then be found in the console tab in a textual form, or in my case, because of using TestNG, I also get a new tab showing the result in a tree structure. So, how does this look like in QF-Test? In QF-Test, test cases will be implemented in a graphical tree, so it's not mandatory to have development skills for creating or maintaining tests. The graphical tree view also allows business testers to read and even edit test cases. Nevertheless, it's also possible to use control flow instructions like if decisions or iterations for repeating steps. So you actually see a fully graphical programming IDE. Test cases can mainly be created by two ways. The first way is the so-called capture replay approach. This means you record the required steps and then you can use them in your test cases. So how does this work? You press on start recording on the QF-Test toolbar. You go to your browser and perform the steps you would like to test. Then you go back to QF-Test, stop the recording, and then you can move the recorded steps, which have been recorded in that graphical manner, to the desired location in your test cases. Secondly, QF-Test supports so-called reusable and shareable procedures, which allows you to create the test steps first, and then you can simply call those procedures by your test cases, again simply via dragging and dropping them. Executing tests work similar to Eclipse, so you can select the test case which you would like to execute, and then you press Start Test Run on the QF-Test toolbar, and the steps will be executed. After the execution, a log file will be created, which we will take a look at later. QF-Test, as well as Selenium, can be integrated with continuous integration tools like Jenkins or TeamCity to run your tests nightly, for instance. The most important topic about UI tests is a reliable and stable recognition of the graphical objects, like buttons, text fields, or the content of a table. Such graphical objects are called elements in Selenium. Selenium offers various locators to determine such elements. It's possible to use XPath, it's possible to use the ID attribute, or the value of other attributes like a stylesheet class name, and it's even possible to use CSS selectors to identify such elements. The test developer has to find a unique way for every element, and he also needs to maintain those attributes in newer versions of the application or the utilized framework. That's why developers should encapsulate accessing the graphical elements to unique methods. In QF-Test, The graphical objects are called components and they are stored to a dedicated section in the QF-Test test suite, which is called Windows and Components. Every component gets an abstract type like button or text field. Additionally, technical attributes like the ID attribute, the name attribute, or the StyleSheet class value, as well as labels in the surroundings of the component or the main text of the components will be taken into account in order to identify the component. A great feature is the very simple access method for accessing content of data objects like tables, trees, or lists. It's pretty simple to identify something just by its index or by the text, which even supports identifying something by regular expressions, so by text with wildcards. QF-Test already comes with the support for various toolkits like Angular or Vaadin or Java Server Faces, but this approach can also simply be extended for further toolkits. The third point is the topic of reporting and logging test results. Selenium doesn't provide any logging framework on its own, so you need to use the means of logging provided to your project, or you try to integrate a third-party logging framework. In my case, that's the reporter class of the test and she framework. QF-Test provides two kinds of logging test results. The first kind is the so-called QF-Test run log, which contains all the executed steps in that graphical tree, what we also know from the QF-Test test suite. So here we see a successful test case. Failing test cases are marked by a red square, what we can see here. And we can quickly jump to the next error using quick navigation buttons on the QF-Test toolbar. We do see the error message, so what we got, what we expected. And in addition, we also get screenshots of the running application at the moment of the error without any specific steps that's provided by QF-Test by default. And interested test developers can also get a stack trace, taking a look at all the current variable values and values of the test data at the moment of that error. Besides the run log, QF-Test provides so-called reports, which can be used to present the test results. Those reports can be created in HTML, XML, or JUnit format. On the left, we see information about the test environment. In the middle, we see a pie chart representing the test cases in a graphical manner. And then in the HTML report, we see all the test cases and, of course, the errors, including the screenshots as well. Last but not least, let's talk about tool documentation and getting support. So who can be asked if a question pops up or something doesn't work as expected? Selenium doesn't offer dedicated tool support, as it's an open source tool. You can send queries to the user group of Selenium, or you check out the links on the Selenium webpage. Additionally, you can also search for answers via Google. QF-Test already comes with lots of documentation and demos, which you can reach from the help menu, so you can reach the manual and a self-starting tutorial showing beginners how to set up test cases. As QF-Test is a commercial tool, QF-Test also provides a dedicated support channel staffed by the QF-Test development team. And you can reach them either via email or via phone. And QF-Test also offers training and consultancy services like reviews and so on. In addition, QF-Test also provides a public mailing list, which acts as a public user forum. We are almost done with the comparison of Selenium and QF-Test. A detailed comparison of both tools, as well as a checklist of requirements for choosing the right UI test automation tool, can be found at the webpage of QFS. There you can also download QF-Test and apply for a 4-week trial license.